It's time to go to the moon with me, one of me, in the Jeff Space Program, and my little friends who will probably die either there or on the way. So, one minor housekeeping issue. I actually started to record this, and I experienced some technical difficulties with the recording software and the game itself. However, I was able to manage to salvage some of the footage, which is very telling about my efforts thus far. So please enjoy this clip, and then we'll pick up from where it leaves off. Okay, apparently we've discovered quantum mechanics. I just reloaded the ship, and there's a lot of engines on it. 216? I gotta see what happens if I try and launch it. I mean, I gotta start some stages. I gotta try. I have to know. I'm sorry, Shanzor. I don't know what the hell that is. But I'm gonna have to start some stages now. Go. Okay, next stage. Holy fucking kapow! Shanzor! Wow. So that's what it looks like when 216 engines occupying the same space at the same time fire off. It's fatal. What is that? Wow. I launched the engine into the thing and it's still going. What the fuck? Look, there's the fuel pod and there's the exhaust. What's that? Oh, that's an SAS unit that was blown through the fabric of space and time. Okay, well, this is a really good omen for our moon landing expedition, but I think we're going to need to make a new ship. As you can see, technological discoveries were made, however, progress was not had. That I do still have that ship created somewhere in here. Yes, this is the Munfucker 5000. Oh my goodness, the quantum engine is also the same thing. It's very interesting. I don't know what happened, but there's 216 engines there, and let me tell you, that's not how you get to the moon. Having said that, we're gonna make a new Munfucker. So again, we could have a larger crew capacity, but it's much more difficult to lift something that has a larger crew capacity, so we're gonna go with one crew member for now. And we're gonna start from scratch. The ship I made last time was very, very similar. Oh man, I'm all fucked up with my controls. How do I pan the camera? I don't remember. Anyway, I'll figure it out. The ship that I made last time was very similar to the first one that we had made for our satellite. I'm gonna put a parachute on there because I'm a nice guy. And we're going to put a miniature fuel pod on here. This is going to be our actual lander. You want your actual lander to be very not dense. Unlike me. One F me. So we'll put some legs on there. And these legs are good because they telescope. They'll actually extend out mechanically. Because we're going to put a pretty big engine on here. Because you can use a smaller engine like this guy. But my deceleration capabilities are pretty limited, as far as, like, understanding when to decelerate. So I need a decently sized engine to do that for me, so that if I fuck up, I can correct. so this is our lunar lander. It won't be returning. It's going to set camp there and hang out, and maybe we'll return another time. But for now, we're just going to work on making a big-ass rocket that will get there. And to do that, we're going to need that different decoupler. Thank you. And I wonder, I don't think we could do this with a single fuselage. Although I do wonder if it might be time for us to move up to a larger set of fuel tanks and rockets. So we have this adapter here. What we can do with that is we can plug it here and then put a big ass big fuel tank. The reason I don't like these so much is because they're not very stable, in my experience. You can put really big engines on them, but I don't really know how much fuel this is going to give us and what it's going to be like when we get to where we're going. So I think what I'll do is I'll make another stage here using these smaller boosters. Sort of a transit stage once we get out of the atmosphere. We use this big guy here to get us out of the atmosphere. I need an SAS on here as well. Preferably a big one. We'll duplicate that and put a two-tank stage there with this engine for vectoring purposes. All right, so we have a three-stage now. It's a single... Whoops, wrong button. It's a single unified body thingy. Are there any bigger engines than that one? Because I was kind of wanting something like... Mammoth. Here we go. Yes. Mammoth. The behemoth. Alright, so another thing that we can do is add some solid boosters to this, which we will do. In fact, I might even just forget about solid boosters and go with liquid boosters. Because they'll give us much more capacity for lift in the early stages of the flight. So I think I'm going to do that. I think we're going to go with a similar setup to what we've been doing with these guys here. And I want them to stay low because I don't want the center of thrust to be very high. Otherwise it'll start to get wobbly and clusterfuck itself. Let's put some SAS boosters on those, and we will put vectorable engines on those as well so that they can have a little bit of control. And we're going to duct tape them all together. And basically, in the end, we're going to strap a bunch of explosives to our ass and vaguely point ourselves at the moon. I'm actually going to demonstrate two ways that you can get to the moon. One way is my derpy way, and the other way is the way that you're supposed to do it. So this will be the Munfucker 6000 in honor of the original fucker of Muns, which ended up not fucking the Mun at all. It prematurely fuck-launch-ulated. That looks pretty cool. I don't know, I kind of want to put some solid fuel boosters on this bitch just to make it even cooler. I don't know if we need them. But at this point, I want them. There are some really big solid boosters that you can put on these guys too, like these fellas right here. So that'll give us a bit of extra thrust off the get-go. So if we fire, what we can do is we can fire these and these, and not this one, until later, when we're ready. And I'm going to want to have these on separate separation stages. You guys are going to go first. And then we'll see if these three liquid fuel engines have enough to lift this entire rocket. I kind of don't think it will, but maybe if these solid boosters get us high enough, as Bob Marley would say, maybe then it'll work. Alright, so you separate next, and you fire. I want those to fire at the same stage. And then you go, and separate stage for this engine, just because I don't want to get fucked with. And this is looking pretty good. You know, I'm sure some of you out there are aeronautical engineers looking at this going, that's going to explode, and I'm kind of hopeful that it will, because that would entertain me. So, Dilming, entertain me, Dilming. Entertain me with your fiery death. Is it tilting on the pad? Well, it's wobbling. I hope that engine's enough to support it without breaking off. Either way, we're going to fire some fucking rockets right now. That's what we're going to do. Boom! Looking good. Looking kind of groovy. It's going straight. Dilming is screaming. Don't be such a Dilming. You big Dilming. So these solid boosters are going to run out of fuel about the same time as we're going to run out of one of these liquid fuel stages. That's kind of interesting to know. I might be able to do some interesting timing with that, actually, if I were to double up on those. But we're getting decent lift. Plenty of lift. Oh, they're gone. I should have separated those sooner, but I wasn't paying attention. I didn't realize that they had finished. And now we're slowing down dramatically. I think what I'm going to do is, on the fly, reconfigure this and fire off the central engine right now. That's right. I did that shit on the fly, because I am super fly. So next we'll separate these liquid state. They're almost done. And we're accelerating. So to make this work, I'm not super thrilled about this wobble, but the ship is built kind of weird. I might not even need these. These might just be extra weight for no reasons at all. We'll see how far this guy gets us. But so I'm going to try to do this my way, the inefficient way, the stupid way, the bad way. And then we'll try it your way, the cerebral, astrophysical way, the efficient way. But for now, we're going to fly with our balls, and I don't think we're going to get very far, just taking a quick peek at this guy right here. Let's take a look out the window. Someone did tell me that you can double-click on this and look out the window even better, which is, I suppose, better. We're starting to tilt a bit, or rotate a bit. I'm super not thrilled about this wobble, but oh my god, whoa, stop! Hold on. Whoa, hold the fucking, jeez. Well, we're going really fast. That's good. But settle down. Remember, we're doing this the dumb way, so we have to do it according to my specifications. I know you guys are all like, you should have turned it 20,000 meters, now you're at 100,000, you can't turn now. Well, just hang in there. We're doing it the dumb way. Alright, so we do still have that SAS unit, so it does give us a little bit. And now we're going to start using this to figure out where our apoapsis is. So that got our apoapsis up to 500,000 meters without using these last two stages of fuel. So that's really good, you know, if you're into that sort of thing. So the moon's all the way over here. And you're thinking, how in the fuck am I going to do my stupid burn all the way out to the end of the universe thing? Oh yeah, that was from an experiment that I did. And it looks like it's going to stay there forever. I tried to slingshot around the moon. It didn't work. So that episode was cut from programming, if you will. Alright, so the thing about burning out as far as we're going is we need to go to 11 point... What the hell? Oh, no, that's not the moon. We need to go to 11.4 million meters. And this... it doesn't look like we're going very far, but it's because I'm not burning all the way. And this is going to become exponentially more dramatic as we go further. Our speed is increasing, and at this speed, outside of the atmosphere, every little bit does a lot for your apoapsis and periapsis and everything. So I'm thinking that it's hopeful that we'll get to try, and I'll be able to show you my buttfuck retarded idiot method of getting to the moon. I was wrong, that's not the moon. Let's curbs that one. This is the moon. Alright, so we got our apoapsis poorly lined up, but it's at 10.4, we need another million meters, and that is just, look, I'm just giving it that much thrust, and it's just rocketing it out there. Alright, so there's our apoapsis at the distance that we need. It's not exactly where we need it to be, but I'm okay with that. So now we're going to do our burnless turn here, which is going to set us up for the actual burn we're going to do. And according to my methodology, this is the easiest, most reliable way to 100% get to the moon if your ship is capable of it. So what I do is I go out to a bajillion million, 11.4 million meters out. And once we reach this apoapsis, the ship is slowing down. And when you're out here, the Newtonian fields are lower, less impactful on your trajectory. So smaller amounts of fuel get you more bang for your buck. So just a little tiny bit of thrust right here will start to expand this, because I'm burning on the axis. Right here, I'm burning towards my apoapsis. And it's going to start to very slowly, but fuel efficiently expand this orbital trajectory. I'm going to increase this because I'm impatient and stupid, as I'm sure you will all remind me soon. Anyway, the moon is coming towards us, and it's obvious that we're not going to hit it. I could do some weird burns and possibly hit it. We're pretty close, actually. It's got an area around it where it will begin to suck you into it. But I wanted to show off my stupid method, And we're going to do that. All right, so we've got our periapsis out here. This is a very strange elliptical orbit that we're on. And here's my guaranteed method of getting to the moon. Once you have an orbit established out here, you begin to rotate Kerbin. We're going to go around Kerbin a few times. In fact, while I'm out here, I kind of want to get rid of this failure debris. I know you want to see everything, but this was just a big, big fucking disaster. So I'm going to end that, and we'll go to the tracking station, and then put ourselves back onto the Munfucker 6000. Really easy way to manage all of your current flights. In fact, you can fly multiple flights in the same time period doing the same thing. So here we are again. It's been a day since we launched, and we're just going around. The thing is that eventually you will intersect with the moon, as is going to happen after this next rotation. I know you're all like, that's the dumbest thing ever, but it works, and it's pretty much guaranteed. We're going pretty fast here. We might get close enough to take a look at CurbSat 1. Now he's going pretty quick, too. So, as you can see, we're going to intersect with the Mun, and this might be enough to actually bring us into the pole. So we may be able to one-shot this. Yes, we are. Okay, so, pretty good thing here. What I've learned is that you want your trajectory to the Mun to be pretty steep so that it's easier to decelerate. If you're coming in at a big angle, it's kind of difficult to decelerate onto the Mun. But it has grabbed us. It has, because of how close we are to it, it has more of a gravitational pull than Kerbin does. Looks like my predicted path for if I were to go through the Moon would be to get slingshotted out. So, if I ever need to do that, where would that put me? That would give me a chance to intersect with something like... He's going real fast. 79,000. 42. How fast are these guys going? 11,000 meters per second. Holy fucking shit. 12,000. Damn. Alright, well, we better get back to this before we crash into the moon. Oh, fuck. Is that fucking... Did that really just happen? Did that really just happen? Are you fucking kidding me? Was I fucking... Oh, come on. Well, parts of us made it to the moon. We, however, were looking at the universe while that happened, and we exploded. So I'm going to launch again, and we'll get... I'm not going to make any changes to the... actually, I will make one stage change. But I'm going to skip ahead to this part. And this time, I promise I will pay closer attention. Actually, okay, so... Since Dill whatever is dead, I haven't done another launch yet. I did show you the way that I used to get to the moon, and we did get there very fast, but we're going to try it the normal way now. I made the one minor stage change that I was talking about, which was to put this big rocket on the same stage as these liquid-fueled engines after the solid-fuel boosters are expended. So that'll give us a little bit of extra efficiency, and doing a gravity turn as well as doing orbital adjustments to move us and slingshot us to the moon is also going to be more efficient. So hopefully that'll give us more fuel to play around with. My biggest hope, though, is that we won't need it. And there is the wibble wobble, the wibble wabble wibble wobble. So we're going to start our gravity turn at about 20,000 meters. You can start it pretty much anywhere. You could start it at, 50,000 meters. I think I'll probably go a little higher because I want my orbit to be relatively high. So I'm thinking maybe we'll go with 50,000. Plus that way it'll give my stages plenty of time to do their stagey thing. I don't know how low you can start it. I guess theoretically if you had something fast enough you could start it at surface altitude. Okay, I'm actually going to reset my SAS here because it is fucked. And sometimes you need to do that once you've launched. You need to stop rotating, you bastard. Okay, it's starting to calm down a little bit. 30,000, I think I'm going to start my gravity turn just because of how annoying this SAS is being. And we're just going to go and start to slowly... I'm going to turn on my fine controls. I'm going to start slow. Well... There goes that thingy. Anyway, what I was saying is we're going to start slowly rolling. This is actually a little easier to control this time, so hopefully we'll get a better result. I don't know if I'm doing it too fast. I'm just doing this by balls and not by not by my TI-82. So I don't know if I'm doing this right or wrong. But we're approaching 100,000 meters, and we are continuing to do our graviturn. I don't know what our orbital trajectory looks like yet. Looking pretty good. I think we should probably be horizontal now, because we're going to end up going really, really far out there. In fact, maybe that's what I'll do, is I'll cut this now and take a look. Now, if I continue burning at a slightly upward, if I go horizontally here, it'll just expand this and it'll keep it at 960,000 meters. But I think I'm going to continue to expand it by not becoming completely horizontal, because I want this to get to 11 point, you know, something million meters to intersect with the moon. There's a couple ways you could do this. In fact, this is probably not the most efficient way to do it, but I'm doing it anyway. Yeah, this is not a good way. I'm going to want to get out here and then do a burn to establish an orbit and then modify that orbit so that it intersects with the moon. So we're going to wait. We did our gravity turn and now we're going, I don't know if this is the right way. Fuck you. This is how I'm doing it. I don't know what I'm doing. Isn't that obvious based on how our last lunar landing went? If you want to call it that. So we're going to start doing our positional burn here to get a orbit around wherever the hell Kerbin is. I lost it. There it is. I don't know if that's the right. Yeah, that's right. All right. So out here at a million meters, it shouldn't take much. Although it seems like it's kind of taking a lot. We're burning at a pretty decent rate and not getting a whole lot of bang for our buck. Maybe this isn't the more efficient way. What's my fuel level like? Okay. I'm probably screwing this up, but whatever. It's gonna burn towards our apoapsis. It's gonna slightly expand it. Not very much, but I just want it to, get to the point where we're orbiting Kerbin. I guess it'd be more efficient if I did a full horizontal burn. Alright, so we're in a very oblong orbit. We just ran out of fuel, actually, on this thing. So, more than likely, due to my idiocy, we've actually lost fuel efficiency. But I'm still hopeful that this pod might be able to get the job done. Okay, so 300,000. So what we're going to do is we're going to coast to the... Oh, that's annoying. I don't want that. I don't want that debris hanging out. Now, there is... You can actually, in theory, you could actually send something up here, push this out into a decaying orbit, and then let it crash back. But it's much easier to just end the flight of it and then go back to the flight you're doing. Whoops. Also, I've never successfully done that. That's something that I'm hopeful that I will be able to do during this Let's Play. But I'm not going to do that right now. we'll do a more controlled environment for that as well. So where were we? Oh yeah, we were coasting. Because we're going to be modifying this orbit, which hopefully won't take much fuel to do. I'm pretty sure it won't. Okay, so once we get to our periapsis, we are going to accelerate dramatically, which will put our apoapsis way further out to the point where hopefully it'll be at about 11.4 million meters. Get this thing to just stand still for a minute. Damn, calm down, bro. There we go. The SAS does nothing because we don't have an SAS unit. And I'm not getting a whole lot of bang for my buck here, but we are moving it. There we go. Now it's starting to expand pretty dramatically. So we're just changing our orbital path by increasing our speed, which is going to move us further out. And once that gets to 11.4 million, like that, there we go. At some point, it'll intersect with the moon. So here we are again, in the same place we were before, spending days rotating around waiting for the moon to pick us up. So I still don't know how to aim at the moon, but I do know how to get into an orbital path which sort of intersects it eventually. Hopefully. Is this going to be one of those ones? I've had one before that never, ever, just through random happenstance, intersected with the fucking moon. This is going to be one of those ones. Isn't it? Isn't it? That's not even the moon! God damn it! I keep doing that! Oh, fuck. Alright. So we're going to... How much fuel do I have left? Not a lot. We may not have enough to decelerate if we do hit the moon. Oh, I'm such an idiot. I love it. You know what's the best thing about being an idiot? Is not giving a shit. Alright, so now we have a chance to intersect with the moon, doing a very similar methodology than... Oh, fuck! Okay, I almost missed it again. Alright, so, the moon did catch us, and I don't think this slingshot is accurate, because according to this thing, it's going to put me here. Where does this come into play? Is it because when the moon is here, it's going to be pulling me? I don't know. I'm almost curious enough to see what happens if I let that go. But no, we're on a mission. And we don't have to do much to get ourselves to the point where we're going to hit the moon here. So what we've got to do is slow ourselves down. And that'll pull the periapsis closer to the moon. And we're also going to burn a little towards the moon. That's the wrong way. I need to be burning this way. We don't have a lot of fuel to work with here, so we're just going to have to do the best we can. Now, the biggest issue that we have is that there will be no free deceleration. None. We're going to have to do it all ourselves. So we'll aim for this big-ass crater here. How much fuel do we have left? Not enough. That is plain. So, this is going to be a failed landing attempt, but at least... here we go again. So, we're accelerating rapidly as we approach the surface of the moon, and we don't have enough fuel to stop ourselves, probably, but we're going to find out. Here's our landing site that we're aiming for. Slow it down. We're 60,000 meters above the surface of the moon. And we're going about 700 meters per second at 31,000. So, let's start a deceleration burn. Let's get it to about... go for 200 meters per second. See if that's manageable enough for us to not explode. Oh yeah, we're nearly out of fuel. But, because there's no atmosphere, every second that we're not doing a retro burn... We're accelerating towards the surface. And that will never stop. And Sean Zor, you are dead Zor. You are very, very dead Zor. And did we just run out of fuel? No, not. Yep, yeah, we did. Alright, so we'll deploy our parachute ineffectively. It doesn't do anything because we're not in an atmosphere. We'll deploy our landing gear. And this time we'll get to watch us land on the moon. Sean Zor! Just sort of... Bounce. We're only going 400 meters per second. It's okay, buddy. You got this. 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 You don't got this. Alright, so another successful trip to the moon. Let's try it again. I'm coming for you, you bastard. Well, this is perhaps our most successful launch yet, because we are going to bang smack into the moon. Without having to do any rotationary bullshit. So we're going to swing it like that, and that little L shape there is going to smack us straight into the surface with lots of fuel left in these tanks, we've got a quarter of a tank left here, but we've got this full tank here for deceleration. This has a good possibility of working if I don't fuck it up by not paying attention and smacking into the surface of the moon. In massive accelerated time mode. Okay, one big thing about landing on the moon, is that you really, really, really want to land on the bright side of the moon. Damn it. Because if you don't, it's very difficult to see when you're going to smack into the ground fatally. And I don't want to deal with that. Okay, so this is going to get us pretty close. We start to do the rest visually from here. Turn off our SAS, because we actually still have some. And our current trajectory is exactly this. That's where we're headed. So we're going to do a minor retro burn to try to get us into a more stable deceleratory pattern. So, slow the fuck down. Slow your roll, homegirl. Okay. That's correct. Alright, so I want our... I want to be going virtually straight up and down, so I'm going to do a little burn this way and see what that does. Okay, that was close, but not exactly. Ugh. Okay, I'm going to turn on fine controls because this is going to be a bitch. This thing is unwieldy as fuck. So that's going to slowly move that up a little bit. It'll also decelerate us, which is cool. But I'm mostly worried about our horizontal movement. I want to get that down to a minimum, if possible. You can see the trajectory starting to get a little straighter here. We want to be going pretty much straight down. Let's see what we got out of that. Not bad. We can do another burn this way. That did decelerate us a little bit, which is good. We're going to need that, but I'm not worried about our deceleration burn until this big guy is off of us, because it's got so much mass that we can't really fuel efficiently slow it down. Okay, so you're gone. You're going to be crashing into the surface of the moon. Hopefully we will not so much. Now we can be much more fuel efficient as we get that fucker blown way the hell out there. Goodbye. Where is he? I don't even see him. Either way, we're pretty close to a vertical landing here. It's not exact, but it's pretty close. So I want to orient myself properly so I know which way is up and which way is down. Okay, my controls are good there. And now we wait for a little while and hope that we have enough fuel in this little tiny tank here to slow us down. I genuinely have no idea if we have enough fuel to slow down. We might not. We're going to start at about 20,000. No, we're going to start right now. Because we are going pretty fast. So a big, big, big retro burn right now. Just taking chunks of fuel, but taking chunks out of our speed. So that got us down to 300 meters per second. There goes our debris. Smashing happily into the surface. Oh, Shanzor, I'm feeling good. We were able to almost half our speed with less than half of our fuel. So we want to keep burning towards this marker, which is our exact trajectory. So I'm going to want that to level out so we can land pretty well straight up. We're down to 135 meters per second. We still got plenty of fuel. I think this might happen. This might just happen. Got a good view from there? No, I don't care. I was hoping he could see Kermen, but he can't, and I don't care. Not my problem. Only thing I want to focus on now is surviving. You can see we definitely don't have enough fuel to get out of here, but that's not the goal of this mission. The goal of this mission is to land on the Mun alive. So we do still have a bit of horizontal movement. Not much I can do about that now except for try a little minor push right here. Come on, get it there. And bingo. All right, so that's pretty much a vertical drop from here. Pretty much. Going about 60 meters per second. We are at 2,500 meters up, which is not accurate, because even though it's the moon, it still operates on the sea level principle. So if you land on a mountain, the surface might be, it's not sonar, you know, the surface might actually be much lower than it says it is. Oh yeah, I'm digging this. This is it. Look, Sean knows it too. He's smiling. Shanzor, he's like, fuck yeah, this is happening. This is really happening. I think 13 meters per second is about as slow as you need to go be able to successfully survive the landing without breaking off your pegs. We are landing on a bit of a slope, though. Oh, whoop, 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 oh, whoa. Oh, don't do that! Okay, no, we're taking back off again. Oh my goodness, what the fuck? That slope was too much, and now we have very little fuel left, so we sort of landed on the moon. I may need to do something very dangerous here. I may need to try to use Shanzor's jetpack to survive. If we run out of fuel before we hit the ground, I have to do a horizontally canceling burn. No, it's slowly. Okay. This might still be salvageable. We have very, very little fuel left. And this is an even bigger slope. Oh, God. Yes! Don't tilt over. Don't tilt over. Yes! Holy fucking shit, that was horrifying. Oh, man. And we have very little fuel left. But, having said that, we are on the moon. We did it-ish. Shanzar is finally comfortable now. Let's take a look at the view he's got from here. No celestial bodies. Whoop, he's upside down? How does that... what? No, the camera's upside down when it does this view. Okay, that's less than normal, but okay. Can I rotate it? No, I can't rotate it. Okay, so apparently he's upside down. Our instruments are going batshit crazy. But, we are going to go on an EVA. So we'll grab onto this ladder here. I can't grab that. But, what we're going to do is we're going to extend our other ladder. So we can safely climb down. Please, please grab... wow. That wouldn't have killed him, but... Get off the ladder. Get off the ladder. He won't get off the ladder. We're going to have to jump. Okay. All right. We'll turn our jetpack on and... We did it. First Kerben on the moon. Woo. So here we are taking the first steps. One small... very small, wobbly, adorable little step for Kerbenators. One really big step for the Jeff Space program. Oops, oops, we're gonna crash. Okay. How fitting. Alright, so gravity very low. We can actually jump up nearly the height of our lander here without our jetpack. And if we do use our jetpack, we can actually fly. Because the gravity is so low. So we can actually hover and fly around a little bit. I want to be careful, though, because, again, this does have fuel. It's not unlimited. Goodbye, lander. Goodbye, motherfucker. Let's go check out this boulder for science. We're going on a scientific exploration. How much fuel do we have left? 80%? Shoot, we got plenty. Let's go scientifically examine this boulder. What is the makeup of this boulder? Does it contain liquid awesome that we could harvest and mine and send back down to Kerben and put into future space endeavors? Our scientific experimentation is not going according to plan yet. Apparently, this is an optical illusion. I'm a boulder. It's moon camouflage. Shh. Don't tell anyone where I am. So you can see the surface of the moon is rather large. It is pockmarked with little bouldery things. We landed on the edge of a big crater here. Not the biggest, though. I think that's the biggest crater on the moon right there. That big bastard. Maybe. I don't know. It's the biggest one I can see. And so, yeah, if we wanted to go explore the surface of a crater, we could go that way. I don't really have enough fuel to do any of that. In fact, I don't have any fuel in the lander, so we're just going to run back out of our magic boulder. The magic boulder. And let's fly the rest of the way, because I'm lazy. I don't like running. I like flying. Very low to the ground. Uh-oh. Oh, no, I don't have enough lift. Oh, goodness. Ow. Our trajectory looks good, our apoapsis is good, our orbit is good. Looks like we might... Oh no, we overshot it! Hopefully its gravitational pull will pull us back into orbit. No, it won't. We're gonna have to stand up. Damn it. Alright, so there we have it. We've successfully put a Kerbman on the Mun. And one of my favorite things to do on the Mun... How much fuel do we have left? Do we need to refuel? Not quite yet. Is to enjoy the view. So, let's enjoy the view, shall we? Oh yeah, by the way, one other thing before we do this. Yeah, the headlight makes science and exploration a little easier. Just hit L and you'll turn on your little headlight. Look how happy he is. He doesn't even really look happy, but he's still happy. Alright, so we're going to enjoy the view for a minute here and experience the world from the Mun. Look at that. That is making me dizzy. It looks like the Twilight Zone. I'm expecting some sort of like monster to come out of my ship now. Here it is, though. The universe as experienced from the surface of the Mun. I do love this particular view. Watching Kerbin rotate. So, unfortunately for Shanzor, he's going to spend the rest of his Kerbin life here on the Mun, because he has no way to get back. Even if he uses little jetpacks, he could not fly out of orbit. Which is sad. But at least he has a little home pod. Maybe someday we'll come back and we will either rescue him, or we could maybe do, like, build some houses for him to live in, so at least he's a little more comfortable. But for now, he's safe aboard the Munfucker 5000, a monument to the success-ish of the Jeff Space program.